شيخ يفان صالح الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى شيخ صالح الحيدان الشيخ ربيع and other than them they focus on the issues of الاعتقاد they focus on the issues of الاعتقاد because it is the foundation of the deen and also it is the da'wah of الأنبياء as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهِ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتِ That we have indeed sent in every nation a messenger proclaiming to them to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone and to stay away from false deities. How do we learn this? From the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So now, as Sheikh Rabi' he said to Ahl al-Bida' بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمُ الْكُتُبِ Between us and you are the books of the Salaf. Between us and you is the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start with the political affairs as it is the case of al-Ikhwan al-Muflisin? Because you find in their khutab, in their sermon, in their lectures, they even bring senators to their masajid. And they speak about the issues, the political issues, about CNN and what is on this magazine and what is on this TV and so on and so forth. And subhanallah, al-Ikhwan al-Muflisin, they got involved in this affair of politics so much so that one time they were selling one of the books of an ex-senator. The al-Ikhwan al-Muslimin, they were selling his book, subhanallah, wallahi. His name is Paul Finley. He authored a book called Silence No More. So basically what he's trying to do, he's trying to get the Muslims like emotionally driven, you know, because he made himself look like he's a judge for the Muslims. You should not be quiet anymore. You should speak about your right and all. And so they got taken for a ride easy. And that's why Sheikh Muqbil Rahimahullah, he said that Ikhwan Muslimin, they are the donkeys of the kuffar. They are the donkeys of the kuffar. They know how to use them, you know. They know how to use them, subhanallah. Look what happened in Libya. They are the one that brought the enemies of Islam to the land of the Muslims. And look what happened now. Look what happened in Libya. It's a big chaos. Wherever they go, subhanallah. In Sudan, ask the people in Sudan, because they have Ikhwan Muslimin as the government there. The situation is terrible. Al-Ghala, very expensive to live there. Because of the Ikhwan al-Muflisin. So wherever they go, they destroy, wal-iyadu billah, a country. And Sheikh Muhammad Nasir Din al-Albani, rahimahullah, when he spoke about their da'wah, he said that their da'wah and their siyasa tajmi' is the politics of congregating the people. And that's why they don't talk about these issues of manhaj. They don't mention al-aqidah. They don't refute ahl al-bid'ah. You never hear them talk about that. Never. They always talk about softening of the heart, or this, that. You know, they're always talking about something that the people have no problem to hear. They will have no problem. But when you talk about Ahl al-Bida' and you refute their batil, they're going to growl at you. Huh? They're going to growl at you. They're not going to be Ikram al-Muslim anymore. It's not going to be that. La, la, la. I'm going to be nice and gentle, and he's going to bring you some coffee. He's going to bring... La, la. Once you start talking about al-bid'ah, that's it. You become his enemy. Because they have this hizbiya, wal-iyadu billah. They have this hizbiya. طيب. So now, Ikhwan al-Muflisin, they call to politics. They are politically driven. They've been doing that for a long time. And that's why Sheikh Muqbil Rahimah, Sheikh Muhammad Nasir Din al-Albani, he said the similitude of al-Ikhwan al-Muslimin is like one of the parable and proverb that they have in Syria. They say, Makanak rawah. Makanak rawah, meaning that the soldier, when the soldier is performing, like you see the soldier going like this, right? He's going like this. He's moving, huh? But is he moving or is he stationary? He's stationary. طيب. So, مكانك راوح. At your place and you are moving. Okay, but he's not moving. In reality, there is no movement. So, this is the da'wah of Ikhwan al-Muflisin. Their da'wah does not move ahead. It's going backward, wal-iyadu billah. They are the ones that destroyed Egypt.
They ruled Egypt for 2 years. They destroyed Egypt. And as a matter of fact, their leader, Muhammad al-Mursi, he has some video clip on YouTube, and you can go and see for yourself. He was asked before he became the president. Someone asked him on Egyptian national TV. Look at Ikhwan al-Muflisin. Their da'wah is not about the deen. Their da'wah is politically driven. They asked him. He said, what is the difference between you and the Coptic Christians in aqidah, in terms of aqidah? He said, there is no difference between us and them. The difference is dynamic. Look at the philosophy. Look at the trickery, wal-iyadu billah. Look at this man. There is no difference between us and the Christians. Subhanallah, hada ajib. How are you going to combine between the lizard and the whale? How are you going to combine between al-kufr wal-shirk? How are you going to combine, wal-iyadu billah, between al-tawheed wal-shirk and al-kufr wal-iman? How are you going to combine between them? And they also asked him, now you're going to be the leader of an Islamic state. Are you going to cut the hand of the thief? What he said? He said that's ijtihad. Subhanallah, ijtihad. So these are al-ikhwan al-muflisin. These are al-ikhwan al-muflisin. This is their da'wah. They don't start with tawheed. You never see them teaching the people tawheed. You never see them doing that. Do they follow the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? They don't. They don't follow the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they don't start with what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started with. So that's why we differ with them. That's why we differ with al-ikhwan al-muflisin, because their da'wah is political. Now you see the difference between al-salafiyin walhamdulillah and people of Ahl al-Bida' from al-ikhwan al-muslimin and also al-tablighiyin. Al-tablighiyin, they put a lot of focus on the issues of al-fada'il. Fada'il are the virtue. For example, how you eat with your right hand, how you sleep on your right side. These are very important matters, but they are not the most important matters. They are not the most important matters. The most important matters are the affairs of aqidah and manhaj. These are the most important matters of the Sharia. So they don't start with the first priorities. And they oppose the da'wah of al-anbiya. They oppose the da'wah of al-anbiya. And they don't start from where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the messengers before him, alayhim as-salatu was-salam, started with. So all they focus about the affairs of merits. That's why they have this book called Fada'il al-A'mal. Fada'il al-A'mal, which is a book of virtue. And this book even has some fabricated hadith, and some have some weak hadith. And they have some Sufi stories. Like, for example, in Fada'il al-Hajj, for example, you find that they mention one of the Sufis. He was making tawaf. And then by accident, he looked at the ankle of a woman, and they say that a hand came out from the Kaaba and slapped him. What type of foolishness is this? Subhanallah. And you find some strange stories in those books. Wallahi, you'll be shocked. Because the author of those books are Sufis. And you got to understand that Jama'at Tabligh, Jama'at Ikhwan al-Muslimin and Tabligh, both of them, the founders, Hassan al-Banna and also Muhammad Ilyas al-Kandahlawi, both of them, they were Sufis. Both of them, they were immersed in Sufism. So as they say, we say in the Arabic language, man ittakhadha al-ghuraba lahu dalilan yamurru bihi ala jiyaf al-kilabi. The poet said, whoever takes the crow as his guide, whoever takes the crow as his guide, he's going to take him where the carcasses are. Right or wrong? He's going to take him where the carcasses are. So the Sufi is going to take you where Sufism is. Exactly. So that's why you find them. As Sheikh Muhammad Nasir Dil Albani, when he was asked about Jama'at al-Tabligh, والدعوة. He said صوفية عصرية. He said modern Sufis. And that's exactly what they are. And they read the books of people of Tasawwuf. They have this in their books. And their da'wa is da'wa Sufiya. So, this is where we differ with them. That when we read the biography of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we find out that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he remained in Mecca for 13 years, calling the people to tawheed. That's all he was doing, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then after that, al-ahkam wa al-shara'i' came down. Because the people, they have to be first well-grounded in the affairs of aqidah. That way when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to them as-salat, they will comply immediately. Zakat, they will comply immediately. And fasting, and other than that, and hajj, and other than that. But these individuals, wal-iyadu billah, they spend years talking about the affairs of politics. And one time, I happened to be in a masjid of al-Ikhwan al-Muflisin, because I was in that area and there was no Salafi masjid. I had to pray there, and they insisted that I lead them in the salat, and I did. So after I finished, he said, can you give us a talk? I started asking them questions. Wallahi, wallahi, they could not answer. And some of them, they were given a wrong answer. Because these people, they've never been taught. They've never been taught. You ask them, where is Allah? They say, everywhere. And then you tell them, no, that's incorrect answer. And then you give them, you know, the answer from Sahih Muslim. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked Al-Jariya, where is Allah? She said, Vissama, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above the seventh heaven, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arshi istawa. So you correct their aqidah, because these people, they've been around, these are commoners, these are just common people. But because they've been around Al-Ikhwan al-Muflisin for years, they never learned anything about the affairs of aqidah. They don't know al-Usul al-Talat. They look at you like you have three heads when you tell them that. You don't know what it is. You see, that's why when you go to their masajid, just look in the shelves. Do you see any books of Sheikh Muhammad al-Abdu'ab there? You're not going to find them. You'll find the books of Hassan al-Banna, Sayyid Qutb, the books of al-Mawdudi, Abu al-A'la al-Mawdudi, and the poet, as I mentioned yesterday. You know, the brother who was with us from Pakistan, he said, he told me, he came to me, he said, I am shocked. I've been as a Muslim for 37 years. I never heard what you're saying. This is the first time I hear this. Because Ahl al-Bida, how they going to give you something that they don't have? فَقِدُ الشَّيْءِ لَا يُعْطِيهِ. Someone who doesn't have something, he can't give it to you. So Ahl al-Bida, they're not going to teach you. I don't expect them to teach you the books of Sheikh Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab. شرح السنة للبربهاري and other books from the books of أهل السنة. They're not going to teach you that. And sometimes they play game. What they do? They use a fatwa by Sheikh bin Baz or Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, because that fatwa suits their desires. That's why they use it. Not because they're going to follow Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen. La. Because, and if Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen or Sheikh bin Baz issues a fatwa against their desires, they start attacking the Sheikh. They speak ill about the mashayikh. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. And this is known about them. They call them, oh, these are scholars of dollars. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. And they don't know فِقْهَ الْوَاقِعِ. They don't know the current affairs. What do they mean by current affairs? Politics. Politics. Okay. Now, you, Ikhwan al-Muflisin, do you know the current affair? What did you do in Libya? You destroyed Libya. What did you do in Syria? You destroyed Syria. What about Egypt? You destroyed Egypt. You brought Rafida to Egypt. They opened the gate wide. When al-Khomeini passed away, the leaders and the figurehead of Ikhwan al-Muslimin, they went to his tomb and they sprinkled roses on his tomb. And they call him Al-Ab al-Ruhi. They call him Al-A'udu billah min hadha al-dalal. They call him Al-Ab al-Ruhi. The spiritual father, wal-iyadu billah, father of dalal. And Sheikh Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhali, hafidhahu Allah ta'ala, he has a clip. I need to find it for you, where the Sheikh actually was alive.